Let's go through a few examples. A teacher with a jazz appreciation class says that his students really like the jazz music that he's playing, and he concludes that the class is causing the students to enjoy jazz music. Another situation, researchers note that drug use is correlated with delinquency. They conclude drug use causes delinquency, and if we reduce drug use, we can also decrease delinquency. What's wrong with the logic in each of these situations? In the case of the jazz music, perhaps students really liked jazz before, and that's why they took the jazz appreciation class, rather than the jazz appreciation class causing them to like jazz. For the second situation, it's possible that people were delinquent, and that's why they started using drugs. In both of these situations, there's ambiguous temporal precedence. We don't know which variable occurred first. If it was the class or the appreciation for jazz, or if it was drug use and then delinquency. Those are just two examples where we can't infer causality. Here's another one, and one that's near and dear to my heart as an educator. We found a correlation between SAT scores and students' grades in college. Can we include then that increasing students' SAT scores will also increase their grades in college? Or what about this one? Some people who commit violent acts played violent video games before committing these acts. Therefore, these video games caused violence. What are the flaws in the logic here for these two situations? This situation is called a third variable problem. It's not necessarily true that high SAT scores resulted in high grades in college. It could be that motivation and effort, intelligence, etc., was a third variable that influenced both SAT scores and college grades. And this situation is called a post hoc fallacy. Just because a person played violent video games before committing a violent act, this doesn't mean that the violent video games caused the violent acts. It could be that people who want to commit violent crimes also want to play violent video games. There's actually a lot of research on this that I'm unaware of, but certainly a simple correlation wouldn't be enough to determine this. Here's the punchline. Get it? Just remember, correlation is super useful, but it does not imply causation.